I'm James from Durham, North Carolina. What got me into the world of cosplay was Star Wars Celebration 5 2 years ago. Did a little father-son trip, and I had no idea that the world of cosplay even existed. I was just a Star Wars fan since I was a kid and wanted to share that with my kid. And I saw all these costumes and that people were wearing, and I thought originally that they were employees. I'm like, okay, you know, they must have spent a lot of money to get all these people hired to be in costume. And then I found out they weren't, that people actually built these things. And once I got introduced to the Mandalorian Mercs and the 501st and realized that this is something I could get into, I started doing it and started building my own costumes. The first one obviously was formal Vader. I had a tuxedo and I thought it might work. I was like, Darth Vader's gotta do something for formal events, like a ribbon cutting ceremony on the Death Star, something. So I threw the tuxedo on, white gloves, and the Darth Vader helmet, and it kind of took off from there. And then after that, I moved into building my first set of armor for my Mandalorian, Slivered Cane, so which is actually a play on name. It's I'm a hockey fan, and I like the New Jersey Devils and the Carolina Hurricanes. So Slivered is Devils backwards, and Cane for the Hurricanes. So, and his colors represent the teams too. And then Darth Nihilus is my character that I went with for the 501st. The Mandalorian Mercs and the 501st are costuming groups for Star Wars. There's also the Rebel Legion, Sith cheerleaders, the Rebel cheerleaders. There's a bunch of different groups out there. So depending on what a person's into as far as their Star Wars goes and what they like, they can choose a group. Like the 501st is 501st.com. You can go right on their website, and they're movie accurate costumes. They have to be perfectly, the way it looks on screen is the way the costumes have to look. So it takes a little bit of work and effort to make sure that a costume is right, and you just basically apply online. Once you're good to go for Mandalorian Mercs 501st, then you can go to different events, which is where the fun starts. Not just the big conventions, but also minor league baseball games for their Star Wars night. And usually it helps charities like the Make-A-Wish Foundation. There's R2-Katie out there, which is a little pink R2-D2, which is for children's cancer. So the money comes in all over to help out a lot of different great charities out there. We did even a roller derby event for the Autism Society of North Carolina, which was a lot of fun. I was in my Slivered Cane, my Mandalorian, in armor on rollerblades, which wasn't the easiest thing to do at first. I did do it, take a little face dive, and everyone looked, and I stood up and I said, well, that's why we wear armor. You gotta stay protected. The next step as far as what I've been doing is we formed a group called the 105th Squad, Vader's Fist Pump. So we kind of threw it together, but it's a multi-genre builders group. So everything from anime, horror, Star Wars, obviously. We have people building costumes and props together. And the group is really based around helping people learn, because I didn't know what I was doing when I first started. And I found that by talking to different cosplayers, there's a lot of them out there very willing to help out. And so we've got a lot of people in the group that do everything from electrical to the metal bending and the working with the foam. It's really good. They share ideas with each other. We've organized in North Carolina. We actually are starting to do charitable events soon too. We're doing, since we're builders, we're gonna try to do work with Habitat for Humanity. We're looking to keep growing, and we've been growing pretty fast recently. Having all these costumes together, and my family gets into it. My wife's a Sith cheerleader. My son's in the Galactic Academy. And together, it's a great thing for the family, I'd say, 100%. It teaches, you know, my sons, they understand now more about charity and helping others because of all the different groups we're part of. It's all charity work that we do, different events with our costumes. So it's like, okay, what better way to mash up things that you like with helping other people? So it's definitely something that I love.